Now, I know it's not Christmas yet, but it will be soon. In fact, maybe if you're a time traveler, you might actually be watching this on Christmas. But today is the 20th. Well, it's kind of 19 minutes past midnight, so it's the 20th for me, but whatever. We're going to do some shitty Christmas games. Or, well, they might not all be shitty, but they sure are exquisite. I have a bunch that I want to... might not get to all of them. We might even do more on Christmas. I will not be on here on Christmas Eve. We'll be celebrating with family. Yeah, I know, right? Disgusting, right? But we'll see what I can do. But regardless, today we're going to do some stupid stuff. And we're going to check it out. So, what is the first game of tonight? Well. Let me just... get this up for you, and let me tell you, we got a real gem here tonight. We got a classic. In fact, it's such a good classic game that I didn't even unzip it. Oof. Boy, oh boy. Oh yeah, if you missed it, by the way, I got a PS4 now. Well, I ordered one. Got the regular version. Heard the pro version is like, you know, it's like a paperweight. So, yeah, I got the regular one, so you might expect a few... Ice of Heaven streams in the future. You might see that game Let It Die, because people have been keeping emailing me about that game, because it's got a skeleton in it, so who knows. But regardless, we're not going to talk about that right now. We're going to talk about the amazing game that is Santa Claus Saves the Earth. And let me tell you, all right? I saw this... I don't know anything about this game, but... Saves the Earth. Okay. I saw the cover art for this fucking game, and I was so mesmerized. I mean, take a good look. Santa Claus Saves the Earth. The font is magical, right? But the fucking face on Santa. Ooh, that boy ain't up to no good. Who's been naughty or nice? Santa Claus is coming with fuck me eyes. oh Jesus, okay. Well, that too, and we have like Gandalf's illegitimate son over here. Squimbly. And who else is on here? We got SpongeBob's rant ass cousin, and just what the fuck is happening? The more I look at it, just Jesus Christ. Oh my god, it's it's like a Shrek's anal warts. Well, we're gonna check this out. It's called Santa Claus Saves the Earth, and am I gonna save the Earth? Yeah, with my Christmas magic. Ooh, okay, let's boot this up. Oh boy, oh boy, I'm excited. Are you excited? If you are, you should fucking seek mental help. Alright, oh boy, here we go. This game is gonna be the best game ever. I hope. Alright. There we go. The unauthorized reproduction, blah 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 blah, piracy harms consumers. Well, Santa Claus, I can assure you that I bought this game legitimately from a tiny Chinese man at a flea market. Telegames. I might recognize... Didn't they make other games too? It's not a bootleg. You know, it's a legitimate game. Evil Gamus! What the fuck is this? Okay. Well. This doesn't seem so bad.
Oh.
Whoa. Now it does. But I gotta say, even though this game seems like shit, it's got a pretty stanky theme to it. Oh, Break it down. I need some little B on this. Swag on my dick. We're gonna check out Santa Claus Saves the Earth. I'm ready, and I recognize that font, but it's not Comic Sans, but it's close. Alright, let's check the hit list. Who made this game? Not many people did. Oh! There were Russians! Let me read that again. That was it? Let me read that. Victoria Tugiva, Mikhail Vladislav Slavlev, Sergei Trofimov, and Terry Gilliam also made this game. All right, cool. Well, we're gonna save Christmas. Man, fuck yeah, that theme. And I wanna get wasted on fucking Christmas Eve, just duking it out to this song. All right, here we go. I can smell the MIDI. Wow, only one day left until Christmas. Thousands of little children are waiting for Santa Claus. And MIDIs. Oh. Oh. Oh no. Meanwhile, very deep under the ground lived a wicked fairy, Neelam. She had a magic copper where she could see everything that happens in the whole world. What? Oh. Today, when she looked into her copper, she saw Santa Claus packing presents for all the children in the world. She became furious. This was made in 2002. How can this happen? Screamed Neelam. I cannot let all the children in the world have presents. What? So Fairy Neelam enchanted Santa Claus, and he is trapped in her magic land. Only a few hours are left until Christmas. What the fuck? Okay. Level 1. And it's a bunch of fucking rotted Twinkies. Or bricks. I can't tell. What the shit, man? Loading. Oh, man. Oh, no. What is this? Oh. You smelling that side-scrolling collect-a-thon crap? PS1 era, it stinks of it. Oh god, the controls. Now let me... Whoa. Can I attack in this game? I can swing my sack. Come back here, I'm fucking Santa Claus. Oh, you can shoot with your... You can shoot balls out of your sack. Ooh. Okay. I'm down. You switch weapons too, huh? Thank god there's no fall there. Oh god, there's that rat thing. And there's a caveman here? Okay, I disintegrated Fred Flintstone, okay. What the hell is this game? Okay, how do I get up here? This kind of has like a Spelunker vibe to it. Not Spelunky. But, okay. Fuck out of here, caveman. So I have... I killed, 3 life forms of Santa Claus, and there's a goddamn television down here, too. What the fuck is this game? Oh, great, I blew it up. Oh, Jesus Christ. So this was released in 2002, and it's a real game, too. Like, wasn't the PS1, like, retired by 2002? Right? I mean, what was the launch year of PlayStation 2? 2001, I think? Yeah. Okay, now the music is stopped. Oh, that's winding up again. Okay, you can look up and down. This game stinks of being European. It was 2000, so wait a minute. This game came out post the last game, so what is this? Is that fucking homebrew? What am I playing here? Ugh. Well, it has a European stink to it, like, I don't know. Some games stink Japanese, some games stink very American. This one stinks very European. Can I define what that means? Well, it's off, and it tries to... Basically, when a game is European, it's trying its hardest to be a real game. But you feel like just something doesn't click right. Like, essentially, you can just imagine the people who made this game just have big mustaches. And they all have, like, lederhosen. And weird accents. You know what I'm talking about! I know it's Russian, though, but come on. Alright. Oh, God. It is playable, it's just... Yo, get the fucking, the Israel flag. Yeah, there we go. I see, okay, so, alright, you become Blue Santa Claus when you collect the Israel flag, okay. Okay, alright, Stroh Party. Still going on. Well, I don't know if Santa Claus is an official sponsor of Konica, so, you know. You can throw down stuff, too? You can't do it at a vertical angle. Oh, God. Oh, no, I'm gonna die! Santa Claus is gonna die! Oh, he fucking... He became fucking cat food! Holy shit, man! You did not make it. Game over. Well, okay. Is somebody gonna get Santa out, or... No? Okay. You know, seeing as this game is Russian, I'm getting, like, Felix the Cat bootleg flashbacks. I hope I don't pick end on the game over screen, and I just get, like, Santa Claus's, like, split skull.
But you never know, do you?
Hate. And I know it's niet, but, you know. That's a stanky loading time. Damn, man. Alright, well, if you're into games that play, like, a CD-ROM game that would be included in, like, a Frosty cereal box, if you like those sort of games, this game is definitely for you. It certainly plays, as I said, like, a cereal box game. But I'm not talking the good kind, like, you know, Chex Quest. I'm talking, like, Kellogg's Platform Adventure with Tony the Tiger. Okay, there we go. Don't I have anything better to do as Santa Claus? Than just, like, you know, killing cavemen in a fucking I don't know, man. Ice cave? Well, it's not even an ice cave, it's just straight up a cave. Ugh, whatever. Oh, Jesus Christ, I didn't even pay attention. Oh, I have an apple now. Oh, that's the ammo for the sack. Okay. Okay, whatever. Well, thank fucking God the music is at least bearable. Okay. Very, very weird thing going on with this game. It doesn't... Nothing really feels Christmas-themed, even though you're playing a Santa Claus. I mean, you'd expect, like, a little bit of... Oh, fuck. I don't know, you know, Frosty the Snowman. You know, what else? Mrs. Claus? The elves? Like, this is just weird. Like, oh yeah, you collect, like, egg cans. Okay, I guess I'm supposed to cling on to this or something? Hang on. Oh, you switch weapons with the R1 and, okay. There we go. What is there a climb mechanic here, or...? Okay, you can actually go up, edges off the platform. That's neat. I mean, it's not totally unplayable, as I said. I would've liked some fall damage, though. Just, like, a spelunker on the NES. Okay, so there's a gun firing down. Just ignore that. Alright, let's go to the right side now. Yeah, I play a lot of Counter-Strike. Unfortunately, me as a European player, I always play with Russians. You guys know this. You know what? Now that we have that, the invincibility, let's go down and, like, to the spikes, I suppose? This is invincibility, that is. I think so. But I can, now that I played Santa Claus Saves the Earth, you know, we can just, all get along. I played Russia's best game. Oh, fuck! It's not... The strobe thing is not invincibility. It isn't. Alright, we're gonna do this one more time, and if I can't make it, then Santa Claus is officially dead, and Christmas is no more, we'll all have to celebrate Kwanzaa instead. Oh, Jesus. It's Lithuanian, bro. Well, I can't tell my European countries apart. I'm from America, right? Can I just kind of skip like... Oh, yeah, there we go. I suppose if I go up here, then... No? You know, the problem with this game is, like, it's functional, sure, but it's not very fun to play. So, yeah, you know. I'm sure there's some kid out there that grew up with this and will defend this game to death. Like, man, you haven't lived until you fucking played Santa Claus Saves the Earth. Like, what game is that? Oh, you know the game where, you know, Santa Claus goes and kills cavemen and, you know, it's made by, like, four people? Okay, there we go. Oh, fuck. I seem to be collecting, like, M&Ms or something. You know what, fuck it, let's just go through here. Oh, you can climb, but... Okay. Okay, if you hold down the jump button, you can climb. Would have helped if I had a manual, but... Alright, I don't know what I just killed, but sure. Okay. Is that cans? Canned eggs and canned tomatoes? Alright. And there's even air conditioning in this cave. Why? Is that a fucking triangle of cheese? He plays an Atari sound effect, okay. Canned eggs. Well, I like to buy potatoes in glass jars. I know that sounds insane, right? But pickled potatoes, they have a distinct flavor, but why I do this is because, they last forever. So in case you need, like, a quick emergency potato every once in a while, because I know you do, pickled potatoes aren't bad. All right. How the fuck do I get up here? Hang on. Can I wall jump? No. No. There's pickled eggs in America. They're like a nasty pink color. Well, I knew about that. Yeah. I don't know if it's the way of going on about this. Hang on, let me readjust the window just a little bit. Okay, well... yeah, it seems we're not making any goddamn progress on this game. You know, when it comes to pickled stuff... I'll just say this, if you don't like pickles, get the fuck out of my stream, okay? Just straight up pickles, man. Just, fuck yeah. I call it night food, alright? I call it night food because it's like... You're too lazy to actually make a sandwich in the middle of the night, so what you do instead is you kinda... Oh, it's a super jump, this is what this is, okay. You're too lazy to make a sandwich in the night, so you just kinda just... finger your pickle jar. And get a fucking, Oh shit, hang on. Gotta do this quick. You finger your... your pickle jar and get like a stanky pickle. That's what I'm into, oh yeah. Okay, you just did it in the knack of time, it seems. I don't know why. Oh, what the hell is that? It's a Christmas demon with a fucking torch. Okay. Is that warp or what is this? No? Okay. Let's see here. You fingle your pinkle. Alright. Gherkins. There we go. Alright, well, I at least want to complete the first level, you know? Again, it's not a horrendously bad game, it's just... Ah, okay, now we can go back. It's functional, you know? It's just... so mediocre and kind of bleh, you know? But man, that music is rocking. There we go. But what about God's Nectar Pickle Juice? Alright, now I don't know if pickle juice is a meme or not, but I hear people drink that shit. Or like, legitimately enjoy it. What the fuck? Alright, I might be weird, but I'm not like, you know, that weird, okay? There we go. Oh, there we go. Oh, I'm back here now. Did I just have like a hat on there for a second? I don't know. Oh, that just goes back here. Shit. What? Really? I have all the keys now, though. What the fuck is breaking TVs do? You can buy pickle juice?
Why?
Pickle juice and vodka. Now we're talking. So there's a clock here. This game raises a lot of questions that I don't think can be answered so easily. There we go. Okay, well... you know what would have benefited this game? Shorter levels, I guess. Or fuck, I don't know. Okay, so to go back here, I guess I gotta... do something here? And here? Oh, okay, I see. Oh shit, can I make it? Oh no! Oh Jesus. Is Santa Claus dead? Oh, come on! So you fall down the pit and you kinda just have to accept your fate. Alright, well... you know, I'll make it game over. That's the end, huh? Alright, I'm gonna brace for something horrific. Seeing as this is a Eastern game, and that's a game over, but let's see. Oh, come on, I mean like a crying kid. Hang on. Let me fix the game over screen, yeah? You know what I would have wanted? You know what I would have fucking wanted? As my game over screen? Actually, the more I look at these pictures, I don't like them one bit. What's happening with Father Christmas over here? Hang on. Man, I guess you tell me, but would this been a good game over screen? I guess beauty is in the eye of the beholder, but... ooh. What are you doing with these kids? Are you, like, grinding them down for your... Christmas magic? Well, Santa Claus saves the Earth. There's barely any goddamn info on this game online. I think there might be a Game Boy Advance port of this game, which is fucking odd. But, yeah, I'm gonna see if there's an ending to this on YouTube. Santa Claus Saves the Earth. Like, if you played all of this to the end, then... oof. Oh, yeah, there is an actual ending to this. It's 30 seconds long, and we're gonna watch it. And I saved us all a bunch of pain by doing this, so, yeah. Oh, who would do this? Who would play this? Okay. After the defeat of the wicked fairy Nilum, Santa Claus makes his way from her... Santa Claus makes his way out from her magic land. Okay. It is now Christmas Day and he gives presents to all the children and goes to... fucking Lapland? Oh man, where's my Finnish bros at? To have a rest until another Christmas.
Did it?
Okay, get... oh, yeah, it would... fucks up, Santa. You blowing fucking fireworks from China now?
Oh! See, I was cracking a joke earlier about Comic Sans, but... ooh! Oh, what a way to fucking end your game, huh? It's like, oh, you suffered, like, you know, 3 days' work of just grinding puzzles and what have you, and suddenly... It's like, what the fuck did you expect, you idiot?
Oh, God.
And that's the end. That is the end. Ugh.
Oh, man, that's some stanky-ass Comic Sans.
Santa Claus Saves the Earth is a classic. I gave it 10 out of 10 Christmas tokens this year, and a real hit. I will be giving, you all, you know, this year under the your Christmas trees. You'll all get a copy of this, all right? I'm not supposed to tell you what you're getting this year, but, you know, I guess it's so close anyway, but, oof. Jesus Christ Almighty. Well, Santa Claus Saves the Earth. I gotta say, there's a bit of a contrast here, too, with the game. If you take a look at Santa Claus in the game, he's got this very dead look to him. But the cover art on the game, this depicts a little bit more realistic Santa, I guess. But, yeah, this one is just a fucking abomination. But, all right, well, Santa Claus Saves the Earth. Okay, let me just close this down. Well, we went from that, and we're actually going to play a game that some consider a somewhat of a classic. That's right. Let me see if I can find this here. Are you ready for a classic? Well, as I said, classic and classic, that's all up to interpretation, but get this off the screen, by the way. So you can find this. And do I have this game? I guess we're gonna see. Yeah, okay. So, some people actually like this game. I have never played it. The only thing I know about this game is that, well, it's a Christmas game. It's the only Christmas game on Super Nintendo. It is the classic, the best, better than the goddamn rest. It is none other than Days Before Christmas. Oh my god, is Joel using Z-SNES? What a plebe. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Do you know it's classic when it's Sunsoft? Oh god, that's a title. Ooh, that's a graphic. Yeah, boy. You got the angry mustached clock, the rat, the Sumerian demon from hell, ghost man, and Frosty the Snowman. But listen to that theme, man. It's days before Christmas. It's a pun. But I'll let you live this time, game, because it's the holidays and it's the season to be jolly. All right, you know what my favorite part about Christmas is? The devil. Let's look at the options here. Skill. Oh, you're not even getting Christmas pony on me, like, you know. Cole Easy. Peppermint Normal, or, Pepto-Bismol Hard. I don't know. Ugh. I think that's like, oh, it's a password system, this. Let me see here. Can I set this up? Is that a password? Yeah. I think it's kind of universal in every land that has a Christmas buffet or a Christmas feast. You always get, like, heartburn and stuff. Oof. I fully expect that this year, too.
Only days before Christmas, Santa slept in his house. An evil plot was brewing, cooked up by an awful lout. The cold and evil snowman scared all the elves away. Timekeeper stole plants from Santa's house that day. But for the vicious louse, this wasn't bad enough. I'm really gonna show him. I'm gonna play.
Okay. I didn't want to hear German there, but okay.
All right. It is the first day. I really should have been playing this every day, huh?
Oh.
Player one, get ready. I am ready. I love Santa's homemade Hadoukens. It's got a homely feel to it. I hear that theme. Is this a friend or is it? Hide from the shame. Okay. I guess releasing the chipmunk in the world was a good thing. Well, the sprite work is pretty nice. The music is great. Oh, free Santa hat! Okay, hang on. Get out of here. I converted him into, commercialism. Fuck yeah, Christmas. Okay. Well, this game is, like, legit. It's not even bad. Oh, there's a bomb! Okay. Yeah, the sprite work here is... Oh, is that a mistletoe? Ooh, sexy Santa sliding down like Mrs. Claus on Christmas Eve. Woof. Yo, squirrel man, you wanna get some sloppy mistletoe action going on? Just look at Santa's bulging sack. All right. What else do we have here? Is that a checkpoint? It's got kind of a Sonic feel to this, honestly. There we go. I like this. It's honestly not bad. I expected this game to actually be like legitimately, you know, scum, but it's all right. Definitely, if you're gonna talk like a good Christmas game, then this certainly fills the criteria. Unlike, you know, Santa Claus Saves the Earth, which has nothing to do with Christmas, but there you go. Level completed. Okay. Let it snow. Santa's falling down a fucking chasm, and he's gonna be yelling for help for days until he, like, becomes a frozen corpse. Oh god, I'm killing penguins now? Okay. Come here. Give me a kiss. Are those elves or squirrels? I think they're supposed to be elves, but... Frosty, what are you doing? I don't know about you guys, but when he does the crouch... Well, Frosty, it kind of looks like, I don't know. I don't like this one bit. And if I twist this image upside down, then... Christmas! Hey, I didn't put it in the game. All I see is a peach. That was the level! Okay, I just fell down the chasm and I'm fine with it. Oof. Ice cave. Oh, Jesus Christ, this game is getting, like, dark now. And I love it.
Player one, get ready.
Holy shit, got spats in it. Okay. It still has more to do with Christmas than Santa saves... Holy shit balls. Then Santa saves the Earth. Okay, let me just approach this carefully, okay? That's a buff-ass reindeer. Oh, okay, I was supposed to save him. I expected, like, a showdown where I had to jump over him, but... There we go. You guys... I am now throwing fire. Okay, Santa's now a fucking flame-mancer. Alright. You guys ever seen a movie called, Santa? Actually, I have it right here. Let me see. Where is it? Santa Claus Conquers the Martians? It's a great movie. It's got Jesus and Santa Claus in it. I'm thinking of that movie. Yeah. If you've seen Mystery Science Theater, you know what I'm talking about. There we go. Let me just get down here. Yeah, there we go. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is some good platforming. It's not bad. Alright. Now they're off going left this... Oh, God! Ugh. That's a solution, but, it's a fucking big-ass level. I'm guessing those are checkpoints, yeah? Well. Huh? So, let's talk Christmas, chat. Yeah. Let's talk turkey, leftovers. What is your family Christmas tradition? Like, that's just unique to yours? I don't have that many. My family, as you know with all Swedish people, we have this weird-ass tradition, right, where we watch old Disney cartoons on the most well-known or oldest television channel, right? And, it's weird, it's a tradition, and it doesn't really make any sense. I'm guessing people in the 40s and 50s used to watch a lot of Disney because it was like the norm, right? So now it's like a tradition to do it, and it's a really like real thing you do. It's not just like, oh yeah, those are the cartoons on TV. It's almost like a religious sect, like, oh shit, dude, fucking Donald Duck's on, you know? But that's what every Swedish person does. Look it up, Google it. Not shitting you. But it's always so weird because you're watching these cartoons from like the 40s and like 50s, right? And because Disney knows there's, you know, all of Sweden collectively watching at like 1 p.m. And it's so goddamn funny when they try to introduce new Disney movies into the mix. It's like, here's Donald Duck, blah, 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 blah. And then suddenly, you know, there's something new on Disney. And all old people in Sweden collectively kind of do this face like, get this shit off! This ain't Donald Duck!
Joel, change the channel! It turned into shite!
There we go. Oh, fuck. I can remember one year when Frozen came out, yeah. I think everybody in Sweden just like muted their television when the songs came on. I need to get over here, but how do I do that? We play my NES and SNES on Christmas Day. Well, I love lasers, you, my man. All right. I think I went the entire wrong way here. No, hang on. Yo, elf, help me. Do I have any like Christmas magic? Okay, I'm gonna do a leap of faith here. I can double jump, or what the fuck just happened? How did I do that? I'm pretty sure I hit the spikes. Like, I guess not. Oh, is that the end of the level? It was like Indiana Jones 3, you know? You just had to believe in the Christmas spirit. Well. Blue magic. Fuck's wrong with Santa's face? Okay. So this game reminds me a little bit of Aladdin on Super Nintendo 2. Just a little, oh god, it's happening. Platforming games like this always turn so psychedelic and weird midway. Man, I am still kind of at the start of the game, but yeah, sure. Oh Jesus. I want to do that again. Now that is graphics at pushing the limit of the serpent. Look at those pupils. Oh yeah. Santa Claus. Well. I wonder if this game has bosses. I hope it has. Maybe that we saw the boss on the cover screen. I would like some Santa hats about now. Oh god. Well, well, well. It is the gift that keeps on giving, this game. It's got good music too. Leap of faith, here we go. Oh, checkpoint. Oh, speaking about fucking Aladdin. I'm scared. Hold me. This game isn't that bad. It's just generic. I wouldn't even call this game generic. I think this game has some heart and soul to it. Like, you know, it's not like a tremendous game, like a must have, but like for what it is, I like it. It's not even just like, oh, I can accept the game. I think it's a pretty good game. It's you know, it's just a fucking Santa Claus platformer, but you know. Okay, did I glitch it or? Oh Jesus! I mean, what do you think? I think it has a charm to it. Here we go. Whoa! Okay, now I'm kind of speedrunning this. I wonder if anyone else speedrun this game. Can somebody look that up? If not, then I'm gonna be the first one at Awesome Games Done Quick or Summer Games Done Quick. You know, the most thematic game for something like that. Oh Jesus! What am I doing? This game is very easy too, so I guess pushing it up on hard difficulty would benefit it, but then again, you don't really want a challenge on Christmas, you just want to have a good time, you know? Alright, let's see what else we have here. The Evil Snowman! Shit. Okay, so I'm guessing this is the boss? Okay, fuck off, penguin. There we go. Okay. The game has nice graphics. I've said that before, but again. Am I killing trout? Oh fuck. Okay, get out of here, snowman clip. Oh jeez, I can't get too ahead of myself. I've started to play this game like I'm playing Sonic the Hedgehog. Which for a lot of people, playing Sonic the Hedgehog on Genesis, like the first one, you always get the bad impression of that game, because it's like, you assume that you're just supposed to hold right and go as fast as possible, but it's really not like that. It's actually like a pretty stingy platformer at times, you know? So whenever I played Sonic as a kid, I hated it, because I'm like, I keep getting like fucked over by enemies, I just want to go fast. You know? You can do that, but you gotta know what you're, you know. Oh Jesus, I'm gonna die. What is this? Okay, now I shoot flames. How you doing, man? Okay, so are you supposed to melt them, or? Oh, this is a hard boss battle. Just don't, get stuck. He's just throwing in the same pattern, though. It's... Okay, that was close, that was close. It's gonna be a one-hit kill if he does get me. Oh! Okay. What is it? Fucking... that wasn't it, was it? That was it? That was it? Wow. Now that's what I'm talking about. Maybe I can finish this in one stream. I don't know. Maybe it doesn't really... Over England. Alright. We're gonna get some, we're gonna... Oh. New segment, huh? Take this, brick bongs. You fucking what, mate? Alright. See, it's England because it's got, you know... Balloons. Yeah, fucking... Okay, let's focus here and just... There we go. Let's try to, like, give one gift to a British child. I'm probably gonna, like, throw coal down Pyrocynical's chimney. There we go. Okay. Can I go to Sweden as well? I'm out of gifts, by the way. Well, some children got their shit. You know, collectively, all of England was naughty this year, so, yeah. Alright. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Your magical access code is TUNFURD! Okay.
What's up, Pyrocynical here?
That sure is a flooded basement, let me tell ya. Did the music just quit, or... Oh no, there's the trump. Okay, there's a trumpet, okay. A little bit of hot chocolate before...
The devil's drink.
Well, I knew this game needed a hard edge to it. We just found it.
El rostro de la muerte.
Holy shit balls. You know, Satan Claus. Flooded basement. What the fuck? Okay, this game just went bananas. What the hell am I playing now? What? Oh, I like this. Satan Claus, all hail. A flooded basement, this is... Okay, it's just a little bit of a power-up. Oh, yeah? Santa knows if you've been naughty or nice. He's gonna stab you right in between the fucking eyes. Well, I'm back to being old Santa Claus now, though, but... Alright. Well, I saw the Satan Claus. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, wait. Speaking of Sonic, here's the rising water. Huh. Flooded basement. See, this is what you get for playing with Z-SNES. Yeah, I am fully aware that Z-SNES is an inaccurate old... Oh, goddammit. Outdated old emulator, but I don't know, man. It's just like a... Driving an old car you love. There's way better cars out there, but just there's something about it that you just can't put your finger on. And it's really trivial too, because you're talking about an emulator here, but you know, I don't know, I'm just a dumbass. I've used several emulators on the SNES Madness, you know, SNES 9X, ZMZ, which I really dislike. ZMZ, if you don't know, is SNES 9X. With the C-SNES UI on it. Oh, Jesus. Except, the sound levels on it are fucked up. Like, this sound is just off. So it's like, pick your poison. Oh! Did the game crash? What? Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah. Here's another reason you might want to avoid C-SNES in general. Shit like this. I like to think that Santa's just he fucked up and he drowned in a fucking stank sewer, right? Hang on, let me yeah, wait. And then after that they had to dig out his corpse and you know, Merry Christmas, kids. Go fuck yourself. Well, Days Before Christmas. It's not a bad game. I do like it. Let's find out if there's an ending to this game, which there probably is, but, you know, still. Days Before Christmas ending. Let's see what we can find. Hmm? You know what? I'll find the speedrun to this instead. Is there a speedrun to this? Oh, yeah, there is. There most definitely is. Alright, let's take a look. There we go. Alright, you ready to, yeah, this is the speedrun. Yeah. Okay, so blah, 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 blah. Let's just skip through here. So this was the sewer level, 5 minutes in. So this is quite a lot. I was like, you know, a quarter into the game, but... So eventually you go into the Valentine's Zone? And then you go to the moon with battle tanks. And then, what else happens? You go to some town. And then you go to, mountains. Alright. Pretty standard stuff, honestly. Okay. Go into some old attic. Alright. That's just standard. I guess it's this is America, right? Because it's got, you know, skyscrapers and stuff. Alright. Back to the sewers, too. Okay. And this is the last boss. Cloud Man. Smell my finger. Whoa. Let's see how this turns out. And he should be dead around here, maybe. There you go. He saved Christmas once again, Santa. Now Christmas has been saved, and oh, come on, let me read that. Oh, Jesus Christ, hang on. Wait, no, YouTube, please. Can I go into this thing? Oh. Sometimes when you just want to find something, it's hard. There we go, okay. Now Christmas has been saved, and all the kids around the world have received their presents. So Santa and his reindeers and go to rest. I kind of hard to see because YouTube's fucking tiny ass window. Because all of you, great, fantastic. Santa's factory. And let's see here. Thanks for playing Sons of Days Before Christmas. Well, inspired by what? Badla. Is that? Oh, that's. Oh, I see. I think that's the name of Santa's bear counterpart. You know, Santa Badla. Soon, yeah, okay. Santa Claus the best, though. Well, yeah. It's not bad. It's not bad. I like it. I like it. I don't know. Badla. I like Satan Claus more, though. Well. I have one more game on the Christmas games list this year. Can you guess what it is? Yo, listen. There's just one game on the fucking computer that's relevant when it comes to Christmas and Santa or whatever. You know what that game is? I see it already in chat. I see people talk about it. Some people don't do, but... Yeah, there you go. I won't even say what it is. I'll just let it pop up on screen, okay? What could it be? What could it be, you ask? Well... Wait for it. Yeah, hang on. Ooh. That's fucking right. Are you ready to fucking play Elf Bowling? Woo! Oh. So this version of Elf Bowling is like, quote unquote, newer. In fact, Elf Bowling 7. The last insult, alright. I played the original Elf Bowling in 98 on the PC. That version no longer works, so we're stuck with this piece of shit. Let's give it a try. Let's bowl. Let's player select. Oh, new? Oh, yeah. Player name, Joel. Ball preview. Oh, you can make your own balls? What the fuck? This is a Guy Fieri ball? Okay, oh, I found myself a fucking bowling ball, okay. Eight ball, the Russian, what do they call him? The Gopnik, the Adidas track pants ball, the trash ball, pumpkin man, Shy Guy, Locked? Oh, man. Earn this ball by playing single player mode. Oh, yeah, I'll definitely be doing that. I'll be playing with my Skull Man. Alright, let's see. We got Santa Claus. We got, Elf Man. Girl. Eagle. Mrs. Claus. Penguin. Polar Bear. Drug Dealer Elf. Shark. Frosty. Very relevant. I think I'll be playing as, you know what? I'll be playing as the crackhead down the street. Sure. Alright. Let's bowl. Oh, this fucking music. It's like listening to a Simpsons movie on repeat. Toy Factory Iceberg. It's a Dingle's Yacht. Okay. Yes. Oh, those are some graphics. Elves use a dirty trick. Okay, what do I do here? Just... I'm the best. Bad pose. So, yep. At one point in the 90s, this game was the hottest shit ever. It seems that they updated it with some 3D stank, though. Yeah. I like the original elf bowling more because the elf would show their ass.
Enemy spotted.
Oh, Jesus. Alright. Yo, let me get that, like, Fred Flintstone curve to it. Hang on. Yeah, there you go. Almost. That elf is dead as shit. Okay, let me see if I can aim to get both. Okay, you get different, like, mutators, I guess. I suppose. Alright. Oh, I see. I gotta avoid the oil now or whatever. Oh, yeah, there we go. Well, I'm just curious why this game really became a thing. I mean, I know it was popular in the 90s because it was just like, you know, a quick little shitty game people would play, but did this thing really continue to 7 games, you know? Oh, jeez, alright. They're all, like, collectively holding their crotches. Oh, it's got stanky maymays in it. Woof! Now that's a sign of a good game, all right.
Come on already.
I guess this game came out in like 2006, so I guess it's appropriate the shitty memes is appropriate for its time. But ooh. It's great. Last guy. Alright, let's see if I can get them both. Mega Bonusotron and this smaller Gutters. Alright, here we go. Oh shit! I'll try that again. I might get hooked on this game.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Oh god. Wasn't the original successful because there was rumor it was a virus? What? I don't remember that. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can do a curve to it. Oh, come on. I like the dead elves. Okay, what's going on now? Oh, they're just chilling the company, I see. A dirty trick, huh? I guess it's appropriate.
Are you waiting for an invitation?
Here we go. Oh, Jesus. I'm curious. This game seems very easily moddable. And I wonder if I can just go into the folder and look for, like, BMP files or whatever. You need to watch the movie they made out of this game. Excuse me? They made a movie out of this? You're not fucking with me, are you? Okay. Strike. Here we go. Check this out. Oh, come on. Oh, so there really was an elf bowling movie. It feels like I'm watching a bunch of, like, snuff photos.
We're in position.
Okay. And, what else do we have here? Just an electrical storm? Are we in the zone? Okay.
So when did this, it came out like 9 years ago and it was about Santa and his elf pirates.
So this really happened, an elf bowling movie happened.
I guess it was the Angry Birds movie of the mid-2000s.
Get in position.
Alright, I'm gonna play like a full game and then I'm just gonna be done with this because it's kind of driving me insane.
I mean, it's an adequate game, but this game feels more like it belongs in, like, you know, like a Shockwave game of the 90s, you know, and it is based on a game from the 90s, but, I mean, could you actually imagine playing full retail price for something like this?
What happens in the North Pole stays in the North Pole.
Oh, shut the fuck up. Oh, boy. Look at that empty face. Oh, God. There we go. You know, the squeaky chipmunk voices kind of reminds me when I, Oh, God, a Chivo! Look at this! Them sweet, sweet Chivos. Player one without using bonuses or dirty tricks.
Okay.
Well, that kind of reminds me of, I got the smiley ball. It reminds me of in, the chipmunk stuff. I used to make my own Worms voice packs. When I was young, I used to just record, like, me saying, you know, booger and butt and stuff like that with a shitty microphone, and I sped it up, and I made my own custom voice pack for Worms Armageddon. That was my childhood, and you probably spent yours more better, but that's what I did. And I rode a tricycle and drank a lot of Kool-Aid.
Alright, I think I've had enough of this game. Disclaimer, what's this? This game is open dynamic engine. With or without modification. Yeah. Here's some legal advice saying you're gonna go to a fucking prison if you play the game. I don't know, reading a thing like this with this wacky music is like, you know.
You're gonna get the chair! You're gonna die in prison! Wow! Your whole family's gonna get sued!
Okay, I'm done with that.
I'm gonna watch the elf bowling movie now, because this seems like a fucking hoax. I can't believe this is a real thing, but... Okay.
Let me see here. Elf bowling. Movie. I can't even find the movie. Hang on. Movie. There you go. Okay.
Oh, wow, I thought this game... Oh, look at this rating, huh? Santa and his brother Dingle as a couple of pirates?
Now, that's a great fucking tagline, right? Or a summary of the thing.
That's where the fun begins in this madcap adventure where Santa must go to Fiji to retrieve the elves, kidnapped by Dingle, and save Christmas.
Alright,
Ratatouille, you know, of course, and Sunday School Musical, classic, Cars Life, The Royal Heist, Tappy Toes,
Brave,
Super K, and Alice in Wonderland. Let's see what all other people liked here. Is that you, Vinny? The Dark Knight Retires. Gladiator Formers. Captain Battle Legacy War. And of course, Metal Man. Oh, I see. So, people that enjoy this shit might also enjoy stuff like, you know, the knockoffs. Cars Life 3 The Heist.
Oh my god.
Speedy Bumper and Lugnut.
Yes, I those are some beloved not Disney characters. What is the real thing? Cars, what is it called? Speed McQueen, whatever his name is. Yeah. Whatever. I can't even remember the name because you know what? The only car movie with a strong character for me is Cars Life 3 and Lugnut, my main man. Oh, there's more. Hang on. This Sky Force, and of course Elf Bowling. Ooh, The Adventure of Scooter the Penguin. AVH, Alien versus Hunter, huh? Puss in Boots. not related to the Shrek one, though. No. Oh, what the hell, man? I didn't even know this shit existed. I mean, I know my video game bootlegs pretty well, but not this kind of shit. Let's just go back to Elf Bowling here and find out exactly what went wrong. Pirate One. Rude humor, huh? Okay. 2007. $6 billion? Oh, God. Oh, that's a lot of fucking, you know, spondoolies for, like, you know, something like this. Do you think they made that money back? Oh, yeah, definitely. Did you know references Gremlins? Okay. Mindless and boring. Well, you do not have any taste. Sweet. And, ha ha ha, what? And heard this is being retooled. Oh, sweet. I'm down for that any day. I want an edgy remake of Elf Bowling. All right. I just want to see a trailer here and see if it's a movie I'm going to watch on Christmas. I actually enjoy a lot of shitty movies on Christmas. In fact, one of my favorite movies I watch every... You know, I said that earlier. What are your personal traditions on Christmas? I watch Jingle All the Way every Christmas. I know that sounds like I'm making a joke or just whatever. But I watch Jingle All the Way every goddamn year. I watch it with my family. In fact, I insist on watching Jingle All the Way every Christmas because watching Arnold run around having his wife be hit on by his neighbor, fantastic Christmas movie, you know. Love it. Actually, legitimately, terrible movie, but you know when Arnold goes, it's terrible time. You know, Christmas is fucking served on a platter, you know. Put the cookie down. Come on, Jamie, I love you, Jamie. Really, it's a Christmas classic in my family, and I don't know why, but it is what it is. Anyway, we're gonna watch this now before I totally go off the rails. Chris, Elf Bowling movie trailer. Okay, here we go. It's 1 minute. 1 minute of your life going down the drain.
This is like a chick flick, except instead of smoking babes, dude, it's a munchkin and a fat guy.
It's great. It's fantastic. Fuck yeah. All right. I don't know what I'm watching tonight. Elf Bowling the movie, you know, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I will be doing more Christmas games, but on Christmas Eve, which is when I celebrated in Sweden, I will be celebrating with my family. But actually, I might be back on Christmas Day, which is when you guys celebrate, the 24th, yeah? So you might actually get a stream on Christmas, but that's more like a punishment, if anything. But, it's great. Elf Bowling. Well, anyway, we're going to move on here to another series of games, and, what else can I say except we found a rather crappy game, a pretty good one, and just something in between that I can't even describe. But you know, if anything else, if you're a time traveler or you just
can't watch the streams beyond this point, you know, and you're going into a fucking asylum. If anything, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And if you celebrate anything else, Happy Holidays. Whatever the fuck. Have a great time. Eat a lot of food. Spend time with family. Have a good-ass time, because that's what Christmas is all about. Anyway, we're going to move on here to shitty wrestling games. So sit tight and, yeah, stuff coming right up, so don't go anywhere.